Top 10 Deadliest Planets in the Universe. Number 10 is HD 189733b. In 2005, cosmologists found a Jupiter-sized exoplanet, HD 189733b, with an unmistakable Earth-like blue color 63 light-years away. In any case, dissimilar to Earth, HD 189733b was not blue due to its oceans and seas. All things being equal, the shading came from its silicate-rich clouds. HD 189733b is additionally lethal. The principal issue is the 8,700 km per hour, 5,400 miles per hour, winds that blow across the exoplanet. That is multiple times the speed of sound, which is madly quick. For correlation, top supported breezes of the infamous Hurricane Katrina blew at 280 km for every hour, 175 miles per hour. Then there is the downpour. The silicate-rich billows of HD 189733b reason downpour of liquid glass to tumble from the skies. That downpour doesn't fall straight down due to the super-fast winds we just discussed. All things considered, this abnormal precipitation falls sideways. One, even in the event that we some way or another discovered our way around that, we would at present have to manage the high temperatures on the exoplanet. HD 189733b is so near its star that it is ludicrously hot. To place that in better viewpoint, it is so close to its sun that HD 189733b finishes an unrest around its star in 2.2 Earth days. Curiously, a day on this exoplanet is additionally 2.2 Earth days long. The gravitational communication between a planet and its star can make a planet have a day and year of a similar length if the planet turns out to be tidally bolted to its star, similarly as our moon is tidally bolted to the Earth. This implies that the planet pivots on its hub in a similar measure of time that it takes to finish one upset around its star. Turns cause days and evenings, and insurgencies cause years. Number 9 is Corot 7b. In February 2009, space experts working the convection, rotation and planetary transits, Corot, satellite found another exoplanet in the Monoceros group of stars 480 light-years from Earth. They called it Corot 7b. Corot 7b is a rough, Earth-like exoplanet despite the fact that it used to be a Saturn-sized hot Jupiter, a term used to portray the colossal, gas-filled planets outside our own close planetary system with tight circles around their stars. Notwithstanding having a rough surface that could uphold life, Corot 7b isn't the spot to be. For starters, its environment is loaded up with minerals that structure rock mists. These mists send stones and little shakes tumbling from the skies as though they were downpour. Regardless of whether people figured out how to endure that, they would be crushed by the madly sweltering surface temperature of the exoplanet. Our own Earth is multiple times farther from our Sun than Corot 7b is from its star. In the daytime, the star in the skies of Corot 7b seems multiple times greater than our own Sun looks from here on Earth. Discussing daytime, Corot 7b may likewise be tidally bolted to its star. A day and a year are simply 20.4 hours long. Too, as you may have speculated, this implies that a large portion of the exoplanet for all time faces its star. The surface temperature of that side is between 1980 degrees Celsius, 3600 degrees Fahrenheit, and 2300 degrees Celsius, 4220 degrees Fahrenheit, which is sufficient to soften rock. Cosmologists accept that the stones as an afterthought confronting the Sun are liquid since they can't stay strong at that temperature. Number 8 is Kelp 9b. Exoplanet Kelp 9b is the most sizzling planet we have ever found. The temperature of its star is around 9,700 degrees Celsius, 17,500 degrees Fahrenheit, which is just about multiple times the 5,480 degrees Celsius. 9,900 degrees Fahrenheit, surface temperature of our Sun. The daytime temperature on the exoplanet drifts around 4,300 degrees Celsius, 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, which is still madly hot. Most stars known to man don't come close. As you read this, Kelp 9b is hot to such an extent that its hydrogen-rich air is bubbling and getting away into space and directly into star Kelp 9, around which the exoplanet turns. Star Kelp 9 is gigantic, arriving at multiple times the size of our Sun. Exoplanet Kelp 9b is multiple times the size of Jupiter and multiple times heavier. The extraordinary temperatures are brought about by the generally short distance between Kelp 9 and Kelp 9b. Both are near such an extent that the exoplanet finishes a circle in 1.5 days. Mercury is multiple times farther from our Sun than Kelp 9b is from Kelp 9. Astronomers accept that exoplanet Kelp 9b will lose its whole environment to star Kelp 9 in only 200 Earth years. At that point, Kelp 9 will have become so huge that it very well may be contacting the exoplanet. Nonetheless, stargazers don't imagine that the exoplanet will pummel into the star. Number 7 is WASP 121b. WASP 121b is one abnormal exoplanet. To start, it isn't round, however, looks more like a football. We mean American football and not the more well-known one that Americans call soccer. In any case, the shape isn't what makes WASP 121b lethal. All things being equal, the issue is the exoplanet's proximity to its star. WASP-121b is so near its star that temperatures float around 2,540 degrees Celsius, 4,600 degrees Fahrenheit. Strong or fluid items can't frame there, and everything simply stays in a vaporous state. This incorporates its metallic climate, which is loaded up with iron and magnesium gases. More terrible, the exoplanet is losing this air to its star, much the same as Kelp 9b. Curiously, the closeness to its star is the very explanation that WASP-121b is loosening up of shape. The star can apply a substantial gravitational draw on the exoplanet. WASP-121b can't avoid the draw since it has a frail gravitational power. It figures out how to incompletely oppose, however, making it twist rusty. Number 6 is Upsilon Andromedae b. Upsilon Andromedae b is one peculiar exoplanet that turns around the star Upsilon Andromedae a, which is 44 light-years from Earth. The exoplanet is excessively near its Sun, finishing a circle in 4.6 days. As you may have speculated, this recommends that it is tidally bolted, with one side forever confronting the Sun and one unimaginably hot. Interestingly, the most blazing zone, the warm spot, doesn't confront the star. All things being equal, it is as an afterthought that never gets daylight. This disclosure perplexed stargazers in light of the fact that the side confronting the star ought to be more sultry. Space experts accept that things are somewhat unique here on the grounds that the breeze moves the warmed air to the contrary side of the exoplanet. Here is one hypothesis concerning how that functions. The warmth from the star Upsilon Andromedae hits the side of exoplanet Upsilon Andromedae b that is confronting the Sun, making the air heat up. At the point when that air becomes adequately sweltering, the breeze transports it to the furthest edge of the exoplanet. At a similar time, the breeze ships the cooler air at the far edge to the side confronting the Sun. At that point the cycle proceeds. The non-stop switch implies that the side protected from the Sun has a solid progression of sweltering air while the side confronting the Sun has a lot cooler air. Number 5 is Ogle 2005 BLG 390 pounds. Gaze 2005 BLG 390 pounds is a rough exoplanet with a slim air found right in the center of our own Milky Way. Each of the three components made stargazers presume that it could contain life when it was found. Nonetheless, they presently accept that it doesn't because of the exoplanet's superlow temperature. 6. The surface temperature on Ogle 2005 BLG 390 pounds is near 220 degrees Celsius, minus 364 degrees Fahrenheit, which is too low to even consider supporting life as far as we might be concerned. For correlation, by certain records, the most reduced temperature ever recorded here on Earth is 97.8 degrees Celsius, minus 144 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature was recorded in a region of super cold Antarctica that has never seen daylight. An endeavor to take around there will wreck our lungs and cause moment passing. Number 4 is TRES 2b. TRES 2b is the most obscure planet out there. It is dark to such an extent that coal will seem lighter if both were ever positioned one next to the other. Deadliest 2b is the size of Jupiter and situated in the Draco star grouping 750 light-years from Earth. Its star is GSC 03549028111, which is practically similar to our Sun. Deadliest 2b is dark since its climate assimilates more than 99% of the light it gets from the Sun. Cosmologists accept that the exoplanet mirrors so minimal light since its environment is loaded up with disintegrated sodium and potassium or vaporous titanium oxide. Nevertheless, being dark doesn't imply that the exoplanet is cool. Indeed, its barometrical temperatures reach more than 980 degrees Celsius, 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit. This amazingly high temperature causes a few pieces of the exoplanet to discharge a red sparkle, much the same as copying coal or electric oven curls. Space experts additionally speculate that the exoplanet is so near its star that both are tidally bolted. Number 3 is Ogle TR56b. Planet Ogle TR56b lies in the Sagittarius group of stars 5,000 light-years from Earth. It is one of the hot Jupiters we discussed prior. Hot Jupiters are regularly framed further away in their heavenly frameworks and later drawn nearer to their stars. Planet Ogle TR56b has just moved excessively near its own star. 8. It is close to such an extent that a year is 29 hours in length, and the exoplanet's surface temperature arrives at 2000 kelvins. Over yonder, the mists are not made of water yet of disintegrated iron. Downpour tumbles to the ground as hot fluid iron. Number 2 is Venus. Destructive planets don't just exist outside our close planetary system. We make them prowl close by, as well. Beyond question, Venus is the deadliest planet in our close planetary system on account of its sulfur dioxide-rich mists. Those mists keep helpful daylight from arriving at the planet's surface and prevent lethal carbon dioxide from leaving the atmosphere. The surface of Venus is loaded up with volcanoes that radiate a lot of warmth and carbon dioxide. The enormous store of carbon dioxide makes Venus harmful for people. The thick mists likewise trap warmth and gas, making the planet mortally hot. Temperatures arrive at an antagonistic 467 degrees Celsius. 872 degrees Fahrenheit. The hot temperature stays consistent everywhere on the planet, even at the shafts. Other hot planets are frequently cooler at the posts. Venus additionally holds this high temperature all year long. Indeed, even the evenings are as blistering as the days. Specialists believe that Venus would be like Mercury if Venus didn't have these clouds. Interestingly, it additionally rains and snows on Venus, despite the fact that things are very unique in relation to what happens on Earth. The snow isn't made of fluid, however, of galena and bismuthinite metals. Precipitation is made out of lethal sulfuric corrosive. Notwithstanding, the high temperature on the planet implies that downpour never contacts the ground. All things considered, it vanishes halfway to frame another cloud. Number 1 is Proxima b. Proxima b looked encouraging when it was found. It circles Proxima Centauri, a red small star 4.24 light-years from Earth. The exoplanet intrigued space experts who imagined that it had water and Earth-like properties. Nonetheless, they before long found that they were wrong. Proxima b is so near Proxima Centauri that the exoplanet finishes a circle in 11.2 days. It is additionally tidally bolted, leaving one side lethal hot and the other lethally cold and frozen. Between the two is a center ground that is more calm. In any case, that area is probably not going to help life due to Proxima Centauri. As we referenced before, Proxima Centauri is a red diminutive person. One quality of such stars is their propensity to deliver sun-powered flares each a few months that strike the planets circling around the stars. Those flares would demolish the ozone layers of those planets, making them powerless against bright radiation from the stars. We noticed one such occasion on March 24, 2017, when Proxima Centauri delivered a sun-based flare toward exoplanet Proxima b. The flare was extraordinary to the point that the star became multiple times more brilliant inside 10 seconds. Proxima b got multiple times the radiation that arrives at the Earth from sunlight-based flares. That is awful for anything living on the exoplanet.